In this video, you'll learn about an unsupervised learning method for visualization called t-SNE. t-SNE stands for T-Distributed Stochastic Neighbor Embedding. It has a complicated name, but it serves a very simple purpose. It maps samples from their high-dimensional space into a two- or three-dimensional space so they can be visualized. While some distortion is inevitable, t-SNE does a great job of approximately representing the distances between the samples. For this reason, t-SNE is an invaluable visual aid for understanding a dataset. To see what sorts of insights are possible with t-SNE, let's look at how it performs on the IRIS dataset. The IRIS samples are in a four-dimensional space, where each dimension corresponds to one of the four IRIS measurements, such as petal length and petal width. Now, t-SNE was only given the measurements of the IRIS samples. In particular, it wasn't given any information about the three species of iris. But if we color the species differently on the scatter plot, we see that t-SNE has kept the species separate. This scatter plot gives us a new insight, however. We learn that there are two iris species, versicolor and virginica, whose samples are close together in the feature space. So it could happen that the iris dataset appears to have two clusters instead of three. This is compatible with our previous examples using k-means, where we saw that a clustering with two clusters also had a relatively low inertia, meaning tight clusters. t-SNE is available in scikit-learn, but it works a little differently to the fit transform components you've already met. Let's see it in action on the iris dataset. The samples are in a two-dimensional NumPy array, and there is a list giving the species of each sample. To start with, import t-SNE and create a t-SNE object. Apply the fit transform method to the samples, and then make a scatter plot of the result, coloring the points using the species. There are two aspects that deserve special attention: the fit transform method and the learning rate. t-SNE only has a fit transform method. The fit transform method simultaneously fits and transforms the data. However, t-SNE does not have separate fit and transform methods. This means that you can't extend a t-SNE map to include new samples. Instead, you'll have to start over each time. The second thing to notice is the learning rate. The learning rate makes the use of t-SNE more complicated than some other techniques. You may need to try different learning rates for different datasets. It's clear, however, when you've made a bad choice, because all the samples appear bunched together in the scatter plot. Normally, it's enough to try a few values between 50 and 200. A final thing to be aware of is that the axes of a t-SNE plot do not have any interpretable meaning. In fact, they are different every time t-SNE is applied, even on the same data. For example, here are three t-SNE plots of the scale Piedmont wine samples generated using the same code. You're now equipped to use t-SNE to gain insight into some real-world datasets. Let's get some practice with the exercises.